The Zogby poll that I mentioned showed that only a quarter of the people who answered were able to name at least two justices of the Supreme Court. One of the questions on the question on the that may be asked of an applicant for U.S. citizenship is to name the Chief Justice in the United States. And as I said, less than a quarter could name two Supreme Court justices. Now, when I looked at that poll, and the poll showed that while that the American people could not name justices of the Supreme Court, three quarters could name correctly at least two of Snow White's seven dwarfs. You show the influence of popular culture. Now, when I saw that, I saw a report of that poll in the newspaper, I had two reactions. The first was that I was happy that these people were not under the impression that Dopey, Grumpy, Sleepy, etc. are the names of the Supreme Court. And my second reaction was it really is not important for people to know the names of the Supreme Court justices. That's really a very low significance. But it is important for people to know what the Supreme Court does. And that's one of the questions that an applicant for citizenship may be asked. What are the duties of the Supreme Court? Now, the INS, or the USCIS, has nice, crisp answers to these questions on its website, so that if you are applying for citizenship, you can study up on questions. And they answer that question in three words. What are the duties of the Supreme Court? And they say, to interpret the laws of the United States. To interpret the laws. Amazing. Three words. Now, if you asked that question to a law school professor, you would not get a three-word answer. You might get a 30,000-word law review article. More likely, you would get a 300-page book. And in at least some cases, you would get a three-volume treatise. And I have a particular three-volume treatise in mind. But I have to say, USCIS has it right on the nose to interpret the laws. When I saw that, it brought to mind a real case that I had back when I was on the Third Circuit when I occasionally came to Delaware, which was within the Third Circuit. This is a true story. It's in the Federal Reporter. You can look it up. There was a lawyer who had business in City Hall, someplace within the circuit, and he went to his meeting. When he finished his meeting, he went down to his car, which was parked on the street, and he saw that he had a parking ticket on his car. And he didn't think that he deserved the parking ticket, so he marched up to the mayor's office, and apparently he created some sort of disturbance in the mayor's office, so they called the police, and he was arrested, and he was taken before a local judge. And the local judge questioned him and came to the conclusion that he was potentially a danger to himself or to other people. So the next thing this lawyer knew, he had been taken into custody, and he waited around for a while, and then the psychologist came down to question him to see whether he really was of sound mind. One of the questions that the psychologist asked him was the following: what would you do if you were the president of the United States? And this lawyer gave a very lawyerly answer. He said, I would carry out my duties in accordance with the Constitution of the United States. Well, the psychologist heard this and interpreted this as a sure sign of mental instability. And the poor fellows then spent 10 days, 2 weeks, I don't know, a significant period of time in a mental institution before he could convince people that he should be released. So if someone who agrees with the ICI, whatever it is, the INS, that the duties of the Supreme Court are to interpret the laws, they might be accused of similar instability.